Hi, everybody. I hope you enjoyed that film. Can you guys also believe that entire thing was shot on this guy right here? I think it looked great. The image quality is absolutely amazing. Also, 8K video. This world we live in now, come on. So to give you an idea of what's gonna be happening in this video right now moving forward, we're gonna have a behind the scenes look at how we shot that film, everything from the creative decisions on shots as well as the technical. So hopefully you'll be able to take that into your own films. So let's jump into step by step of how we made this film. All right, welcome to our first shot. So when you watched that short film that we created, you probably noticed the big fancy transition where we went through the door and now we're down by the water. I always think it's important to put a lot of time into your first shot. They say that people make a decision if they wanna watch your video or not within the first 10 to 15 seconds. Honestly, with attention spans now, I think it's like 2 to 3 seconds. So make sure your first shot is perfect. So we're gonna do a 2 take. So if you look here, this is without any lighting. And then this is what the shot looks like with lighting. The nice thing is that it's more even and a little less dramatic. When you're shooting on a phone, you wanna try to get the cleanest image as possible. So I like adding light. Then we set up the camera, we put it on the wide camera. I had my arm in it so that it looked like a POV of opening the door. The camera also has in-body stabilization, which is really nice and we'll add to it. But if you can also be another stabilizer, it's an added benefit. It makes the shot look really good. So if you guys don't own a slider or a gimbal or anything like that, one of the things that you guys can do is put your phone on a tripod. In this case, we can shoot at 8K. So we're gonna switch to the 8K mode. And what you can do is if you shoot a little wider in post-production after the fact, you can actually create a pan movement by keyframing that in. So when you have your 8K footage, let's say it's this big, you can now zoom in on that clip. You can pick this as frame one and then have it digitally move across the frame and you can add movement in post-production. It's a little pro tip for you. All right, I feel like one of the classic things when we start shooting cinematic sequences is we add the zoom, zoom. Those are black bars. It looks more cinematic because that's what we see in Hollywood. One of the things that a lot of shooters do is that they just shoot in normal 16:9 aspect ratio and then they add the black bars on afterwards and they slightly reframe. What I appreciate about the Xiaomi Mi 10 is that in their camera app, they actually allow you to add those bars in while you're shooting so you can frame properly in that aspect ratio rather than being like, hope this looks good with cinematic bars. This phone has 108 megapixel sensor on it. Look at it, you just keep zooming. What is happening? Seriously, this phone's amazing. We're super stoked. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, we're at the end now. If you saw any value in this, please press like, it's right down there. On a side note, there's a competition going on right now. You guys can submit your own cinematic videos for your chance to win one of these phones or some of the other Xiaomi products that are available right now. I love you guys. We'll see you soon. I wanna go take some photos of Luna because 108 megapixels, let's go.